Hi everyone, welcome to my week in Schull in pictures. So the night we arrived, last Saturday, 10th of February, we went out for a drink to Newman's pub, and I drew the beer taps, which I thought looked really nice. If you haven't had Hoegaarden, you absolutely have to try it. It's absolutely amazing. It's this middle one, and it was served to us in this enormous glass with a slice of orange on top. Delicious. And we remarked on how heavy the glass was to the barman. And he said, "That's the glass you want in a bar fight." So we were thinking, oh, right, okay. So yeah, well armed for a bar fight anyway. But this one here came back the next day, and I sat in an alcove just opposite out of the snow. Yes, it was snowing. And a lady came towards us in a long full-length fur coat. And she said, you want fur coat in the snow today? And an old man came across the road, a really doddery old man, but a nice old fella. And he said, "Do you know, I've just come from having my pancakes." Yes, delicious. There's a cafe next to Newman's, just next to it. And they have lovely pancakes. And he said, "I always ask for lots of maple syrup." There's lots of English types in Skull. So this is Newman's, really nice yellow everywhere. Lovely pub. So we were down in Skull for a 420 racing week. Our youngest daughter is 13, and she sails for 420s, which is a two-handed boat. So she goes off into the sea with her pal, her racing partner, and it's all very, very fabulous and very serious. But the weather was wild and blustery and very cold, but I managed to get the quick sketch in anyway before they started. So, that was Monday. Later on that day, I sat and painted these fishing nets near the quay at Skull, and the lobster pots just beyond them. And it was a bit of a lackluster lighting situation, and I went back the next morning early and the sun was out, and I just put in these shadows, and it just made all the difference. So, you know, don't be slow to say to yourself, right, give this another shot. You know, if the lighting changes dramatically and you think you can do something better with it. Oh yeah, this one. Mm-hmm. So my little dog Reuben, who's my little boy, my little baby, he was a guest in the house that we were staying in. And well, you know, everybody knows what happens when a male dog is in a house with another male dog. You know, they mark, you know, they cock their leg. So this went on a couple of times and something had to be done. So off I went to the local centre and I bought this packet of nappies for Reuben, and I brought them back, and here he is wagging his tail because he's a good boy. He's wearing his nappy here, and as I put this on, I just couldn't stop laughing because Reuben on his back and wagging his little tail. I had to cut a hole for the nappy, which I never had to do with my own children, I must say. And it was exactly like when I would have changed nappies for my kids. And I really felt like saying to him, "Now you're all clean, nice, you're a lovely, clean boy." But yeah, Reuben, nappies, I don't know. Mm. So so then the next morning I managed to get a sketch of the guys launching off the beach at Skull. And they're amazing kids. They just hop into their boats. You can see them there, hop into the boats, and off they sail into this gorgeous bay with the islands just to the south. Now we're in the very, very, very tip of Ireland. We're in the far southwest, right sticking out into the Atlantic. So yes, the weather is a bit, you know, dramatic, but also all these islands make the bays quite sheltered, so it's a fantastic spot to learn to sail. The water is always gorgeous down there, beautiful greeny colour, and the pebbles on the beach were just so pretty. And I decided that day to try and get a close up at some point. So the next day on the jetty, these lovely boats were just tempting me to paint them, a little bit of rust and so on, just gorgeous. And now I was sitting there on my own, waiting for showers to pass, and it was a bit blustery. And there was a car going up and down, you know, very, very slowly idling, the engine idling. And I was the only one there. So I decided that, you know, this is where all the drugs come in. And, you know, now that they've seen me, and I've seen them, they clearly can't let me sort of go home, you know. So this is the kind of thing you think of when you're sketching on your own. But and then I thought, that's terrible, terrible slur on Skull. But then I saw a sign saying, "We need your help. Anybody who's seen any drugs or, you know, anything like that, please report to this number." So, yeah, it is a fact that the very, very ins and outs coast of Cork makes it ideal for people who are up to nefarious activities. Yeah, kind of a blue building here. I brought my boy Paddy, who's 16, and his mate Max, who's also 16. I thought they'd like to do a bit of urban sketching, and I wanted to show them something, get them to draw something that would never look amazing, so they wouldn't feel under pressure to make something beautiful. And I thought if they focused in on this very odd Japanese lettering painted on the side of this building, that'd be a good start. Sure enough, they did some gorgeous drawings, perfectly drawn Japanese lettering, but the only problem was the rain did not let up. And when I say rain, I actually mean hail and snow and completely sideways rain and hail and snow. And it was just awful. So I had to keep darting back into the car where the boys were, I don't know, munching sandwiches and chatting and sort of desultorily making the odd sketch. But you can see here what Schull High Street looks like. It's full of these dramatically painted buildings and it's lovely. I thought a signpost would make a nice sort of way to pin down the whereabouts of the town. You know, the signpost is always nice for that. A desperate attempt to draw the teenagers launching, standing around. I love the look of the teens. You know, they have this certain look to them. But that was as far as I got because the rain started coming in with a vengeance. I nipped down to the shore to paint these pebbles. And as I walked home, the rain washed all the colour off it. So I went back the next morning very early and obviously with a nicely newly dry page, and I painted the pebbles back again. They're all lovely shades of purple and sage, not much in the way of blue, which is very different from here, and it's lovely. And then I thought, well, why not just, you know, give them the context. So this was the morning of a race. This was, I think this was Saturday morning, the last morning. And so this is a guy putting some I don't know what he's doing, putting flags up on a rescue boat or some kind of a sailing boat, to do with the racing. Yeah, so at the water again, that beautiful green colour. So that's Skull. Oh yeah, so then later on I decided to go to Hackett's, a local pub in the middle of Skull. Absolutely fabulous place, serves amazing food, and I have to say, incredible soundtrack. For those Luddites among us who don't know what Spotify can do, you know, you put your music in and then Spotify decides what you clearly like and plays loads more like it. So I sat there listening to the Mamas and Papas and the Animals and Nick Drake and all these amazing bands and Van Morrison and all cool stuff from the 70s and 60s, and I just drew away. Now, what I liked about this was the fact that you can see through to the front whilst you're sitting in the back room, and I liked the way the light came streaming in. This is the pussycat who lives in the pub, more or less. He doesn't actually live there, but he comes and goes as he pleases. And it's interesting that you're allowed to bring your dog in, and the cat doesn't bat an eyelid. No matter how mental the dog's going to try and get at the pussycat, just doesn't care. And then here on the left, there was a foursome. I'm missing one guy here at the left. And they were chatting away, and they were there for hours and hours. And they're being served through the hatch, their pints and their coffees and all the rest of it. By this is Max, I think his name is Max anyway, it's the young barman, that's the hatch. So in theory you could sit there all day and get served. That noise, by the way, is my dog, who's just found the lid of a bottle of Coke and he's amusing himself because nobody else is. So oh yeah, the hearts, they were there because it was the day after Valentine's Day, or 2 days after Valentine's Day. So yeah, so that's Hackett's, and that's the end of my week in Skull. Hope you enjoyed it.